Hi, this is Katie from A Mother Thing. Today I wanted to do a video review because I'm actually really disappointed. I went onto a website. It's called Nifty Thrifty, and it's basically a site that allows you to get a mystery box. I mean, they have things you can buy that you actually see, but one of their kind of cool things that, well, I thought it was cool, was you can buy mystery t-shirts and mystery flannel shirts. And given that I'm a big fan of both, I thought it was a really cool thing to try. So what it is you go on their site and you can order the vintage t-shirts, which are touted as being buttery soft and well worn and really cool, and they're $5 a piece, and you don't know what you're getting until you get it. And they have flannel shirts, which are again supposed to be old and used but well worn and comfortable, and those are $8 a piece. So I decided to go ahead and try my hand at it, and I ordered five of the t-shirts and two of the flannel shirts. And I just got my package today, and I have to tell you, I am so disappointed. I really was thinking that this was going to be a really cool sort of way of getting vintage fashion. T-shirts, you know, it's kind of potluck, and I get it that it's not always going to be something that you really love. And, you know, I wasn't necessarily expecting like licensed t-shirts and things, but what I got really was not what I was expecting, and I don't think it was as advertised. So I wanted to share with you today these t-shirts, and you can make your own decision. I mean, they seem to have some really good reviews, so maybe people are really happy with it, but for me, this was just not at all what I was expecting. So let me show you first. I'll show you the flannel shirts. Now, first of all, on their site, it didn't really tell you, it asks for your size, but it doesn't really tell you how their sizing works. So I assumed that by choosing a size, I was choosing a women's size, and I went for a size large because with, this area, a lot of times, I can't fit into the mediums. I definitely am never a small, but sometimes some stores I'm a medium, but I figured if they're vintage, they're probably going to run smaller. So I went for a large, and I was really disappointed that everything was in men's sizes. So there's no fit to it. So right out of the box, everything's going to be too big for me. But I can totally deal with that if they were really good shirts, but I don't think they were. So the first one, the first flannel shirt is this one. It's by the original Arizona Jean Company, so it's not, bad quality. No rips or tears or anything. It's a bit dark and dismal, but again, it's supposed to be grunge, so I can kind of deal with that. It is not soft. It's soft as flannel is soft, but it's not soft and worn. It feels kind of just like a little bit kind of crusty. Clean, but kind of crusty. So it's okay, but it's not exactly what I was hoping for. This one, again, is kind of dark and not the greatest. It's Sierra Pacific, which I've never really heard of, but it is very soft and very worn. It feels quite nice. The sleeves are actually really short on this. So despite the fact that it fits well and it's nice and soft, it looks weird. So again, it's just going to kind of be a run around shirt, something that I might wear if I'm painting, and that's about it. Now let me show you these t-shirts. These are what I was really excited about, these vintage t-shirts that were supposed to be buttery soft and well worn. Okay, so the first one that I got, the first one I took out, it's not the worst. This is the best of the bunch. So what it is it's an Amstel Light shirt, and it's I Love Burger, apparently. That's the front. It is very soft, very thin and worn. It has paint on it. Yeah, it's covered in paint stains. Clearly, someone else had the same idea I did about the flannel, and they just wore this to paint their house. The back is kind of funny. It says, "True love makes me thirsty." Yeah, and it's, again, a beer and a burger shirt. Again, it's soft, it's okay, but it's covered in paint. Someone used this to paint their house. How is that worth any money? I wouldn't buy this from a charity shop. And I do all of my shopping at flea markets and charity shops because I much prefer to buy used clothing, recycle, reuse. I don't buy new very often, but I don't buy paint stained shirts either. So that's kind of crap. So the second one, it's, I don't know, it's a Natural Wonders shirt. It's a wolf. I didn't wear these when they were in fashion. Not that they were ever in proper fashion, but at one point, a lot of people were wearing these. I was not one of them. There is not buttery soft. It's just old. And I think whoever had it before me, when they had it new, they didn't wear it very often because it's not worn in. It's like a t-shirt you would buy at a truck stop, and it's horrible. So the third one, right? This is somebody's company shirt. It's Pendergrass Landscape Contractors, and it has their phone number on the back. I guess for kitsch value, it could be okay, but there's no way I would ever wear this. Again, I don't think it was ever really worn at the time. It's not soft. It's shapeless. It's just a crappy old t-shirt, and it's no good. Next one. Oh, you'll love this. This is great. This is, again, for kitsch value, I guess it could be okay. It's a soccer team from New Jersey, the Pinelanders from Howell, New Jersey. And it's got someone's number on the back, but you know what else it has? Signatures. This was a team shirt that they just took a magic marker to, and people actually just signed it. It's got names on it. Tim, Cody, I don't know, just random people's names. I don't want these people's names on my back. Why would I buy this? I would not. And I mean, the color could be kind of cute, but again, it's just some horrible team t-shirt. And then the last one. This is kind of weird, and I'm not one to be offended, but I'm sure some people would be offended. It's Fat Catholic Softball. So I don't really know what that's about. It's the Sorrento Subs Adam and Eve Hair Designs TJ Excavating Inc. So it's obviously a team t-shirt. It's a softball shirt with all the sponsors on the back, which again, for kitsch value, I guess is kind of cute. But again, never worn. It's one of those ones that it's never been worn. You can tell. Somebody wore it for their team photograph, put it in their closet, never wore it, gave it to a charity shop somewhere down the road. It was bought, sent to Nifty Thrifty, and they sent it to me as if I would wear it. So there you go. All these horrible, horrible t-shirts that I would not recommend to anyone. Now, I believe on their website they say that satisfaction is guaranteed and you can send them back and they'll send you new ones, but honestly, this was such a strikeout that I'll never try it again. I was really hoping. I think online thrift shop where they send you a mystery box is really cool. It's a great idea, but its execution is terrible. It is lacking so badly. And I hope someone who knows what they're doing will start this company again with a new tag and actually send t-shirts that are worth sending because these are awful. Like, I just don't understand why anyone would buy these. If you've actually had a good experience through Nifty for Thrifty, I'd really love to hear about it because I just don't understand right now. I just think they're terrible. The flannels, okay, we're gonna wear them. I will keep them. They'll be fine. But every one of these t-shirts is gonna go to my charity shop. $25 completely wasted, plus the 18 for the or the 16 for the. For the flannels, which aren't going to get much use, but at least they'll be good for something. So yeah, that's my Nifty Thrifty review. I'm Katie at amotherthing.com. Come and visit my blog. Maybe you'll find something you like. That's it. Have a good day.